New York is many things to many people.
And once you've experienced it, you'll never ever forget it.
There's always something new going on in the city.
And the food scene is insane. The burger is a burger. Your table manners are atrocious.
Terrible. This is the city to eat and eat well.
This doesn't seem like chicken.
This is like a real serious New York style sandwich.
Oh, here.
That's why from uptown to downtown and across town, we're taking a bite of the Big Apple. This is The Crawl New York.
Stretch to say that New York is the center of the universe. It's been called the Big Apple, the city that never sleeps, the city of dreams, and a city so nice they named it twice.
Margarita and I are here for a little over a week, but we intend to take the biggest bite out of the Big Apple.
We promised you a New York crawl.
And we intend to deliver. We're crawling from downtown to uptown, and we begin in the East Village. Once considered dangerous and off-limits, today the East Village is an altogether different story.
So this used to be called Needle Park.
Why?
Well, I guess by the name, everybody used to come here for a fix. It really was like no man's land. We were not allowed to come down here. Alphabet City was like dangerous. But look at it now.
While it retains much of its bohemian vibe and laid-back spirit, the East Village is possibly New York's most exciting food destination, an incubator for aspiring young chefs and restaurateurs. And some of these new and inventive dining concepts really hit home.
The news is Filipino cuisine is having its moment right here, right now.
And I heard that here in the East Village, there's one restaurant that took that giant leap forward to introduce Filipino cuisine to some of the toughest customers in the world. And I'm talking about New Yorkers.
Meet Nicole Ponseca, the founder and creative director of Jikni and Maharlika restaurants in New York, and perhaps the person responsible for putting Filipino cuisine on the Manhattan map. Nicole, where are you?
Where is love?
Oh my gosh!
Service with a song. I know.
Hi.
Hi, Nicole.
Which one? Award-winning.
Award-winning Chori Burger. It was inspired by my travels through the Philippines. And this one, obviously, is from Boracay. And then we just won Best Tiki Bar in all of New York City.
So. Best Tiki Bar in all of New York.
And Best Burger.
And
New
Best
York
Burger.
Well. Yeah.
Even better than that one that goes by the name of...
Secret.
Shake your booty.
We beat them too. It was astounding. It was with Time Out. It was their readers. They voted. And then New York Magazine listed us as the number one tiki bar.
Number one tiki bar and burger in all of New York.
And it's Pinoy. Yeah, that's the best part.
Maharlika Restaurant and Jeepney Gastropub, 5 blocks apart, both in the East Village, are two Filipino restaurants opened by Nicole and her partner, Miguel Trinidad. In Time Out New York's 2014 Battle of the Burgers, Jeepney bested dozens of contenders and emerged the winner with their original Chori Burger.
So this is achara and then lettuce, tomato on the side, the camote fries.
I'll try the camote fries.
This is our crack sauce.
Crack sauce? Is it legal?
Yes.
These are good camote fries.
Thank you. So this is a double patty here that we created, and it's half beef and it's half longanisa that we've uncased. So it's literally a double patty. And then we like to put an egg on it because why not? It's a silog and a burger.
Yes.
You know what was the hardest thing is that when I first opened, my menu was alphabetical. And I had Adidas and Balut as the first two things, like crazy.
Cheerio.
Here we go. I can taste the longanisa.
Yeah.
Very good. Cool. I can see why you won. This is the best burger in New York City.
Mm.
Wow.
so good without sharam.
I like how you can really taste the pinoy in it.
That's true.
At the same time, it's so appealing. Well, not only do they have the best burgers, they also have the best cocktails. With concoctions like Ayala Avenue, Juice Mary Joseph, and Pinay Colada, Jeepney was recently named the best tiki bar in New York.
Notice, you get the little one, I get the big one.
It's a very masculine drink for me here. Thank you very much.
Well, look.
Oh, you're a little piggy.
See, I get the cute one because I'm here the pig. Okay. So this is mine.
Okay, I'll have to settle for this. But likewise, I mean, these are award-winning drinks that have made Jeepney very, very popular.
This bar is an homage to all the original tiki bartenders in the 1940s and 50s. Not a lot of people know. It was American-owned, but all the bartenders during that era were Filipino.
So, no.
Yeah. And Frank Sinatra and Ava Gardner, they loved getting served with the Filipinos because they would keep all the Hollywood secrets.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
This is potent. We should keep
this... This one too, actually.
Keep this away from an open flame. Kidding aside, the tiki cocktails at Jeepney Cafe are the bomb. They're fruity and refreshing, but certainly pack a punch. You know, it doesn't hurt that after a cocktail or two, you're transported to some beach in the tropics. But I'm about to be jolted out of my reverie.
Well, you know, it's so interesting. Like when you sat down here and all those titas and their daughters, when they saw you, they were astounded and were so enamored of you that they saw you sitting here in the flesh.
Yeah, but that's so you just aged me, you know, by all those titas and titos.
And their daughters, yeah. And they were so, they recognized you instantly. And I think that that's what Jeepney is about. It's like, it's about culture, pop culture, memories, childhood
pop
memories.
Culture.
Yeah.
Dudes,
right.
You're pop culture.
Dudes. Yeah, so that's, well, now that was a rude awakening from my tropical fantasy, though.
No? Yes.
I'm pop culture. Okay. I'll take that as a compliment.
You should.
I will.
Thank
Here's
you.
To you,
Thank
Nicole,
you.
And to the wonderful group at Jeepney and Maharlika.
Thank you so much.
And
continued success.
Mm. Keep on going, guys. You make us proud.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Love you. Mahal ka namin.
Where is the love?
Mahalo, halo.
Tayo. Kakanta rin tayo.
Where is the love?
Oh, yeah, your turn.
My God.
Your turn.
There. I'll pass. Just how popular is Filipino cuisine becoming in New York? In the East Village alone, there are four Filipino restaurants within walking distance of each other. There's Maharlika, Jeepney, The Ugly Kitchen, and Mama Fina's House of Filipino Sisig.
Sam Santa Maria is the son-in-law of Mama Fina, and he's the guy behind the bar at the East Village restaurant.
House of Filipino Sisig. And this is supposed to be a spicy sisig. Am I right?
Well, you can see the sili. Yes. Okay, I'm gonna take a bite before this gets
Yeah,
cold.
You go first. But it's hot.
Mmm.
Really?
Crunchy.
Well, that's the way I like it.
Yum.
That's the way I like it.
Mmm.
Sam, are you Filipino by any chance?
I am, but I was born and raised here in the United States.
Okay.
Mmm. Crunchy bits. Yeah. Yum.
This is really good. That's why I love sisig. Crunchy.
No, and it's good because it's like chopped up really fine.
Mm-hmm. You know, it had everything I was looking for in a great sisig. You know, it's got the heat and the
yes.
crunch and the linamnam factor.
Yes, linamnam. That translates to like a flavor bomb.
So these are the recipes of Delfina Dolor, better known as Mama Fina. Sam is married to the daughter of Mama Fina, Aming, whom he met in Bicol.
When there's a Bicolana in the kitchen, you can expect things to get really hot.
Yes.
So are you satisfied?
Like
Does it deserve
before.
Two bangs?
It's the best bang I've ever had. And now it's my turn.
Yes.
Yes.
A A short walk away from Mama Fina's is Ugly Kitchen.
Ugly Kitchen. It really is a catchy name. Chef Addis Tuazon is the man behind the dream. Addis represents the best of the Filipino. Motivated, creative, and passionate. He made his New York dream come true. And it all began at the NBC Executive Dining Room.
I was a dishwasher there. I'm the only Filipino, four of us in the kitchen. And then I got really close to the boss, and he put me on the front of the house. And he said, "What do you really want to be?" I said, "I wanted to be a chef, but I got no money, obviously."
You're good. You're good.
Yeah.
Whoa, okay, go
Actually,
ahead.
Actually, that guy wrote me a check and put me in the culinary school.
Oh my gosh.
I'm not lying. Yeah.
Now that's a real New York story.
Yep, yep, yep. And I have to tell you, I read books about Jack Welch. At one point in time, I mean, when he was with GE, he was considered one of the best CEOs in America.
Yes, absolutely.
You know, the guy is a guru.
Yeah.
You know, and then he gave Addis Tuazon a check to pursue culinary school. I mean, how amazing is that?
Super amazing, but it's what he did after that that gets even more interesting.
To Ugly Kitchen.
To Ugly Kitchen, thank
Ugly
you.
Ugly Kitchen.
So wait a minute, you have to tell us why Ugly Kitchen.
Oh, you have to guess. And then I'll tell you exactly why Ugly Kitchen.
From what I know, Filipino food has always been known to not look so pretty. So
that's
could
one.
That be one?
That could be, yeah. How about you?
Like to say it's something which is the opposite of what it really is.
Yeah, that could be it. But the main reason why Ugly Kitchen is because when we opened this one, we were trying to register it, the health department at that time to open. My main idea is to name it Dirty Kitchen, because back home, we all have Dirty Kitchen, right?
Yeah.
So we wanted to name it Dirty Kitchen, but when we're trying to register it, sabi nila, you cannot name this Dirty Kitchen because of the health code.
Really?
Yeah.
The health department
so,
said
and
that.
Then the inspector itself said, why don't you name it Ugly Kitchen? And then we came out like, you know what? Let's name it Ugly Kitchen.
Ah, are you paying him royalties?
And now here. Here we come. 7 years later.
Can you imagine? Seven years.
No? Bilis.
That is a feat, Aris, to survive, I mean, 7 years in New York.
Yeah,
I mean, you must be doing something right. Look at this.
The food in Ugly Kitchen is anything but ugly. Aris is a talented chef, and everything from his boodles to his doodles is amazing.
Today, we're having a bone marrow salpicao and a good old escabeche.
Bone marrow salpicao. This is really, really good.
Yeah, the meat is really yummy. I love the parts with the fat, too.
Well, Margarita almost single-handedly wiped out the bone marrow salpicao.
I did?
Yes, you did.
Sorry, but not sorry.
Not sorry.
Kulang na lang konting patis, no?
Patis and calamansi.
This is one of my most favorite things, sorry.
You'll never guess who was dining here the first time I came to Ugly Kitchen. No, but you know when I was here, first, I had a great time, by the way. I just don't recall much of what happened, but it started off really nice. It started off really well. I saw the actress, Marisa Tomei.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, here?
And I'm a major fan.
Eating Filipino food?
Yeah, my cousin Vinny star.
Oh my God, my cousin Vinny.
Right? That's how I remember her too. With Joe Pesci, right?
Yeah. Yep. Marisa Tomei.
Wow. Oh, your turn.
I thought you'd never let it go. I was saying, well, she's taking her time, huh?
No, and even your escabeche looks super. It's also nice that you don't temper the flavors for the market. Like, this garlic rice is the way we would have garlic rice in Manila. And that's how we want the foreign palate to enjoy it. Because sometimes there's a temptation to, like, temper everything, not too much fish sauce, etc. But I think that when you do that, then you take the soul of the cuisine away, right? So, but look at this. It's like, you know, everybody needs mouth spray after having the fried rice, but it tastes super Pinoy. Yeah.
And for some reason, it tastes perfect with a Prosecco.
Yep.
Ha. Cheers. Cheers.
Even you're tired, you're poor. Your huddled masses yearning to breathe free. Goes the inscription on Lady Liberty's pedestal. Between 1892 to 1954, it is estimated that 12 million immigrants passed through Ellis Island to find a new and better life in America. In the early part of the 20th century, the Lower East Side was home to millions of new immigrant families. Today, we're heading to Manhattan's Lower East Side, where Katz Deli has been serving customers for over 100 years. You can't come to New York and not have a sandwich at Katz.
Jake Dell is only in his early 30s, but he's the fifth generation owner of Katz, and his mandate is to keep things the same.
That's what people expect. They want to see it exactly the same, right? They want the sounds and the smells to be the same as when they were kids or the last time when they were here. And so that's very important for us to maintain that tradition and that atmosphere. So we do whatever we can to change nothing.
Katz is an old-school delicatessen that still follows the same methods of smoking, pickling, spicing, and curing that was first used when the store opened in 1888, bringing the flavors of the old world to 19th century New York.
Oh my God, it smells wonderful in here. Hi, thank you. So you have to get a stub when you enter and make sure you don't lose it, whether you buy something or not. You need the ticket. If you lose it, it's $50.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
I'll make sure to buy something.
I'll go with the...
Just the corned beef. Yeah. So, we're having one pastrami and one corned beef.
One pastrami, one corned beef.
Oh my God.
The encouraged tasting here.
Always the same. Ooh, corned beef. Oh. Different, but good, too.
Nice and light. Mm.
David Spector?
I'm sorry?
Are you David Spector?
No, sir.
Oh, okay.
It's a curse.
Even at Katz Deli.
See, that's a real celebrity sighting right there. But in fairness, I Googled David Spector, and there is a resemblance.
Well, speaking of celebrity sightings, Katz has seen them all.
We've seen so many people over the years. I mean, as you can see, all the walls are lined with famous people. For me, I really enjoyed meeting Danny DeVito. He's just sort of a fun loudmouth, you know, and I remember him seeing him as a kid, and I enjoy that. Much shorter than I thought he was going to be. I'm also tall, though, to be fair.
I adore Danny DeVito.
I adore Leonardo DiCaprio.
He came in one time, was sitting in the back, and then at the end, like, wait a minute, I think that's Leonardo DiCaprio. And we went over and we're like, do you want to join the wall? And he goes, all right, fine, but hurry up, take the picture quickly. We're going to sit down, we're going to do it, you're going to run behind me. I don't want anyone to know I'm here. And then I'm going to run out. And I was like, okay, yeah.
That's the photo right there. Hi, Leo. Jake has a photo somewhere in this wall as a two-year-old in a hot dog costume. He practically grew up at Katz. In fact, he was only two when that famous scene from Harry Met Sally was shot right here and immortalized forever.
They closed down the store for the day. They filmed at that table right over there, and it was an all-day shoot. A lot of takes, a lot of cake orgasms that day. People come in at least once a week to recreate the scene. I mean, it's, if not more. And it's usually more likely that it happens at 3 a.m. than it does at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. But it certainly happens, and we've seen everyone do it. Guys, girls, young, old, you name it. We've seen it all.
You know, we almost went the full nine yards.
Yep.
You know, we had what Meg Ryan and Billy Crystal had. Here at the same table, well, almost, because Margarita did do the, you know.
Well, that would have been too embarrassing. Oh, okay.
I'll have what she's having.
So I guess we're going to have like a serious New York moment.
Julius.
At Katz Deli.
Here at the table where Harry Met Sally.
Of course, it had to be exactly
movies of all time.
Exactly where they shot it.
Exactly, though.
And what's really nice is you come here, things don't change. It's always the same. Food tastes the same. The vibe is the same. This is like a real serious New York style sandwich.
You ever forget the pickle?
Of course. And the green tomatoes.
Life is a pickle, believe me.
Katz is a New York institution for a reason. They serve seriously delicious pastrami and corned beef sandwiches. Juicy and tender, great with mustard, even better with pickles and green tomatoes.
There are other items on the menu, like matzo ball soup, knobblewurst, and liverwurst. But the size of the pastrami sandwich would easily feed a city.
You know, my daughter brought me here a few months ago for the first time. And there was a line. There was a weekend.
Oh.
And people, regardless of... You can be in a suit. You can be in shorts and slippers. But here, it's
everyone's the same.
You get your ticket. You fall in line. And you order your food.
That's New York for you. Nobody gives a hoot who you are.
At this point in time in my life, my happiness is where my children are. Oh. And that happens to be in New York.
You're going to make me cry.
There we go.
Home is where my kids are.
Yeah.
You know, and that's just the way it is. And what a big bonus for me that they now call New York home.
Well, New York will always be home.
I'll have whatever she's having.
Orchard Street in the Lower East Side, and this is like one of my most favorite neighborhoods because this used to be like where we would come down to get like cheap luggage or cheap pantyhose during the 70s.
Did she just say pantyhose? I mean, did you just say pantyhose?
Hey, that was in the 70s and the 80s.
I know, I haven't heard that in decades. Now it's so gentrified. Now there's even a Filipino restaurant.
In the area, can you imagine? That says a lot about where Filipino cuisine has reached in New York City. Hey, I see the Philippine flag. We must be at Chismis.
That's exactly what we were talking about. And you know it's Pinoy because...
Benakitodits.
Benakitodits.
Five thirsty.
Five thirsty.
Chibog na.
Chibog na.
Okay. We're at Chismis.
Jappy of Zealous is the chef behind Manhattan's newest Filipino restaurant, Chismis. In local dialect, Chismis translates to gossip, as in, what's the latest Chismis? And the latest Chismis is this.
Filipino food is only going one way, and that's forward, up and above.
But that's not Chismis. That's a fact.
The space is very new. We opened June 7th, so it's about maybe 7 weeks old.
Palang, ha?
Bago.
Well, wow, you guys are doing amazing things.
Thank you.
Because yes. People have been hearing so much about Chismis.
Thank you, that's why we're here.
Chismis is in the most amazing location in the Lower East Side. It's a very hip and happening place, and some of my favorite restaurants are just steps away from Chismis. There's Wild Air and Contra across the street, and Trapizzino is just around the corner. Chismis is definitely in good company.
The Tenement Museum is just a block also from us. Delancey in Essex, it's really historic. From a merchant's point of view, this is where everything started. The immigrants came here and they built a fortune. On Rivington, this corner also used to be known for ties. Everyone from Wall Street, where Italians came to buy ties here in New York, was in this corner.
Namit Gid.
We've had so much food since we started the food crawl,
but I can smell smoked fish.
I'm feeling little knots in my stomach because I'm excited to taste Filipino.
Yeah. This is supposed to be a vegan pancit.
Okay.
And this is the version of lying from Chismis, which apparently is their best seller.
I lean on the side of spicy food, so I'll do with the lying and then...
Little more?
Maybe just a little bit more. Thank you.
You have to have rice with it.
Of course. Lying is not the same without rice.
Wow. It's so mahamot.
No, mahamot.
Okay, let's do this. Aligie, my favorite ingredient in the world.
We're nice.
Now I can smell the aligie. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Yeah, it looks so good. Okay. One twirl for you.
Thank you very much.
And one twirl for me.
You know, I'm fascinated to find out how does the American palate, you know, react to something like our aligie.
Well, you know, it's such a flavorful ingredient. And I think New York is about people with adventurous palates.
Mm-hmm.
So Filipino food is something that's, I'm sure, very new for them. And ingredients that are so, like, packed with flavor, but very different from what they've had before. And serving it up to them here, I think that that's what excites them about chismis.
I hope they appreciate it as much as we do.
Yeah. Mmm. Mmm. Oh, wow. Mmm. Mm. Oh, my God.
Lamit. Grabe.
Mmm. Lamit. In Bisaya.
In Bisaya.
This aligi pasta, oh, my gosh. It's so good. Because it's nice angel hair. So you can really taste the crab fat. And then the crab meat is like, my God, it feels like they just steamed it like a few minutes ago.
That's your point. It's just falling apart.
Yeah. Really good. The lying was spicy, huh?
Really? I thought it was mild. The lying is not spicy according to my standards, or maybe other Filipinos, but it just has a taste that resonates in the mouth. I can feel it from how it's just going all around. It's very tasty. You know, I wouldn't say spicy is the word. See if you agree with me.
Mmm. Mmm. Well, it's spicy, huh?
I said, bye now.
Yummy. I want more. You have to have the vegan pancit too.
I'm guessing there's a lot of vegan longganisa.
Mm. No.
There's some chicharron.
Vegan as in?
It's just vegan.
Vegan as in?
Ilocos.
Vegetarian.
Oh, gosh, I thought vegan. Ilocos.
Or did you mean vegan as in Ilocos?
No, vegan as in?
As in vegan.
Vegetarian.
Oh, as so in it's, vegetarian.
It's vegan. It's vegan. Vegan, say it with me, vegan.
Vegan, longanisa. Ooh, nice. Mmm, manamit gid.
Umugani.
All the way here in New York, I can't believe we're speaking in Ilonggo, eating vegan.
Vegan.
Pancit. Really nice laing. And
really,
pasta
really
with aligi.
And all of this was the genius of isa ka Ilonggong chef. Amo, di ba, si Chef Jappy.
I can't believe on Orchard Street, I'm eating food that's Ilonggo inspired by an Ilonggo chef. Gosh, Filipino food has really come into this world. And let's not forget about dessert. They have the most amazing Silvana.
From Dubaguete.
Queens. It's from Queens. There's a Filipina, Ana Casimiro, of Cucina de Casimiro, who makes these most amazing Silvanas.
This dessert is our number one selling dessert here in Orchard Street. Another Ilonggo dish.
Mamostre na ta?
Oo.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Mmm. Chewy. Oh my God, there's like a wad of butter in the middle. I love it.
Namit ah. The butter, yeah. Namit, another. Home run.
Super nami.
We have Filipinos just starting to walk through the door. From the Lower East Side, we crawl to Soho. New York neighborhoods are acronym happy. There's Soho for south of Houston. Then there's NoHo for north of Houston. Tribeca is short for Triangle Below Canal Street. Nomad for north of Madison Square Park. And the list goes on.
And it's cute because each neighborhood has its own personality and its own set of quirks. Not so long ago, Soho was an industrial zone where factories and warehouses used to be. Then it became the enclave of artists like Andy Warhol and Philip Glass. Pretty soon, the fashionable crowd took over. Today, it is one of Manhattan's most desirable neighborhoods.
Baltazar is a Soho brasserie that has enjoyed a following among fashionistas and celebrities since it opened its doors in 2007. And Margarita and I don't have a reservation, but it's past 3 p.m., so we take a chance. And voila, a table is available.
Baltazar serves French bistro classics like oysters, escargot, chicken liver, moule marinié, steak frites, and even eggs benedict. And, of course, we order everything.
Including several bottles of bubbly.
Oh, you bet.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you. To the crawl. It's 3:30 in the afternoon.
And look at the buzz of this place.
There's not an empty seat in the entire restaurant.
I tell you, this is like my biggest dream. I want to have a restaurant in Manila with this din, this kind of noise. It's something that you just, you know, you can't buy it. It's such a New York thing. Oysters first, right?
Oysters first.
Perfect. Thank you, dear.
There you go.
Yum, yum. Mmm. Oh my God, they really make the best meal.
If it wasn't for you, I'd never be coming here. I'd probably just be outside with the food truck.
Oh, come on.
But I'd be Margarita Flores, okay.
I'm so happy they killed you off. So you're here?
I'm so happy they killed me off too. My God, this is so much better than Cavite oysters.
No, they're really yummy.
It is.
I have to say.
Well, it was there was mignonette for the oysters and persillade for the escargot. I mean, you just learn something new every day.
Yeah, and don't forget the béarnaise for the steak frites.
Béarnaise for the steak frites.
Snails and champagne, naman.
Yeah, yeah. The snails and champagne.
Okay, I'm gonna do this for you. Oh, you start.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Yum! The best.
Mm.
Actually, their escargot is really super.
Wow. Ang sarap.
My turn.
Your turn.
Oh my God. So this is just the chicken liver and foie mousse. But these look like caramelized onions, I think, on the side. It was 3:30 in the afternoon in Soho. It wasn't lunch, it wasn't brunch, it wasn't even dinner. Right? But there was not an empty seat in the place. And then, of course, the iconic fries of Baltazar.
Okay, why do you call it iconic fries of Baltazar?
Because they're so known for their fries. Their fries are really good. They're skinny and they're like always like crunchy.
And then a funny thing happened.
A very New York moment.
We made friends with the neighbors.
No, I'm just going to say, have you noticed? We haven't even kissed in front of the camera.
Eduardo. Of course he can sing, he can dance, he can sing.
I have so much talent, you will not believe it.
Really? Oh my God, I bet. Sing me a show tune.
I've done everything. The only thing I don't do is sing and dance, to be honest.
Oh.
That's almost 36 years. I'm 63 now.
What?
We don't.
See, he's older than me.
I'm only 30.
Yes, I am.
What the hell is going on with the
exactly.
No, you know what it is? We take the sun really well.
And we did what any true Filipino would do.
We invited Christy and William to Manila.
I just want to know that every time you have a food crawl, I'm always available.
This is the life, right?
Yes, it is.
Right?
Wait a minute, we're not done yet. We head to NOLITA, another acronym for North of Little Italy.
Lombardi's claims to be New York's first pizzeria, opening its doors in 1905. Gennaro Lombardi, originally from Naples, is credited for developing a New York-style pizza.
Oh my God, Lombardi's, Lombardi's.
Okay.
Can I get the one with a lot of cheese?
Why? Because it's your show? Well, don't be fooled. She's Asia's top female chef. And it's her show.
No. And he's the actor's actor. And it's our show.
Oh.
I'm a cheesy person.
Okay. What's the right way to eat pizza?
Fold. The Italian way. Fold and then subo. One, two.
This is good mozzarella cheese.
You know, Lombardi's has always been number one in the Zagat Guide.
It is very good.
Again, another place in New York that doesn't change. Oh my God, sarap.
Oh my God, sorry. Go. Yeah, you. Your table manners are atrocious.
Terrible.
I was just kidding. What I wanted to say was, you eat with such a gusto.
Okay, now that I do. The crust is smoky, it's a little burnt. Then it's crusty on the outside. The mozzarella's nice. And then there's just the right amount of tomato. So it's not like smothered. Sarap, so good.
Best way to call it a night in New York.
Bellini's at Cipriani with a possible celebrity sighting.
James Franco just happens to be inside.
Oh my gosh.
Pero hindi namin pinapansin, of course.
We kid you not. James Franco, and guess who else was at Cipriani's? Adrian Brody.
Amateurs. It's a classic New York moment.
The original Harry's Bar is in Venice, but New York has everything, so of course you can find the Harry's Bar experience here in New York at Cipriani's. Cheers! Oh my God, cheers. You chugged it.
I know I did. Shame on me.